How old are you today?
3.
And what is your name? And where do you live?
In Nebraska.
Who's your mommy?
Sonia.
Who's your daddy?
Daddy Burpo.
Who's your sister?
Cassie.
That was 8 years ago. Looking at Colton now, you would have never guessed that he almost died in 2003. His father, Todd, tells about Colton's near-death experience in the book, Heaven is for Real.
And he started throwing up into the toilet, you know, and at first we're like, okay, he's got the stomach flu, because the doctor said it was going around.
Colton's condition only got worse as days passed. His doctor discovered his appendix had burst, and infection was spreading in his body. Time was running out.
Then we knew we were in bad shape when they said, well, you need to come out the hallway. They separated us from everyone else, and then someone came to us and started talking to us that we got to have surgery on your kid.
It was tough. Seeing your boy be lifeless when he was a very vibrant child.
And it was at that moment that we were looking at each other. I remember my wife holding Colton in that hallway, just us. He's not even moving. We went to the surgery prep area, and I remember them hauling him away and him just yelling at me, Daddy, don't let him take me, Daddy, don't let him take me. And I went back to the pre-op room where we had left some stuff, and I was finally alone, shut the door, and I just broke down, and I was mad at God. I just frustrated, fed up. And I remember telling him, I said, God, after all I've done for you, and now you're going to take my kid? This is how you treat your pastors.
And I was calling our prayer chain. I was calling anybody that would be on the other line to get Colton on the prayer chain because it was bad.
We were there in the waiting room for an hour and a half, maybe. Then I remember the nurse coming out. Is Colton's daddy out here? I'm like, yeah, well, Colton's in recovery and he's screaming for you. And I'm sitting there with him. And I remember my son in that room then looking up at me and goes, Dad, do you know I almost died? And my first thought was, maybe he overheard the nurse say that, or maybe they thought he was under anesthesia, you know, and he wasn't. But it wasn't till 4 months after we got out of the hospital that we finally listened to our son.
And that's where I got to see heaven. No, Jesus and some angels came and flew me up to heaven.
And I said, so Colton, what did Jesus look like?
I knew that the first person I saw was Jesus. He was wearing white robes with a purple sash, and he just came down nicely and gracefully.
Well, Dad, Jesus has markers. Dad, Jesus has markers. I didn't know what he meant, so I finally asked the right question. Colton, where are Jesus' markers? And he drops his toys down, and he stands up, and he just points, Dad, they were right here. He takes his fingers, points to the palms, then he bends over and touches the tops of his feet. And looks up to me, that's where Jesus' markers were, Dad.
When I was in the throne room of God to start with, so I got to see what that looked like. I was upset because I didn't know what was happening. What God did is he used people or things that I liked to calm me down. From there on, I felt better.
And one day we're traveling together and he looks up at me and, Dad, you used to have a grandpa named Pop, didn't you? Like, yeah, he's really nice. Really? Yeah, you used to play with him as a kid and work with him on the farm and shoot stuff with him. And I'm like, yeah, how do you know that? Well, he told me.
A figure came up, and he was Pop. He asked me, are you Todd's son? I said, yes. He said that he was his grandpa, so that's where I met him.
Yeah, Pop, I was very close to him. And he was my most significant male role model when I was a kid growing up. But he was killed in a car wreck before I turned 7.
I was busy paying bills again, because that's my job. And he came up and told me he had 2 sisters. Well, he had to say it several times before he finally got my attention. And finally, I put myself down and looked at him and says, what do you mean you have 2 sisters? No, I have 2 sisters. You had a baby die in your tummy. And I just looked at him like, well, how do you know you have 2 sisters? Well, she told me. And then he proceeded to describe her.
She looked like Cassie, but she had brown hair. And first time when she saw me, she just came up and hugged me.
We knew this was true because he said she kept hugging me. She wouldn't stop hugging me, Mom, and I didn't like that.
Well, I'm not really the hugging type.
I had miscarried the weekend of Father's Day weekend, which made it even rougher. And we thought we'd dealt with it. We got over, accepted that the baby had died. But when he said he had two sisters, I think I was in shock first and then trying to realize, what is he telling me? And so I knew that he had seen her. And after he described her, and he said, she's just waiting for you guys to come to heaven.
You know, as we talked about heaven and he was telling me all these wonderful details, I just felt like I had to ask him, did he want to come back?
I knew that I was leaving heaven because Jesus came to me and said, Colton, you need to go back. Even though I didn't want to go back, he said that he was answering my dad's prayer.
I remember that prayer. That irreverent, that disrespectful, screaming at God prayer. I was like, he's answering that prayer?
Today, Colton is a healthy 11-year-old and shares his heavenly journey with boldness.
I learned that heaven is for real, and you're gonna like it.